Hi there, and welcome to my latest review. And this is a new model railway related review to come of 2018, I believe. And I'm going to kickstart my 2018 videos with this Kato power pack for the Kato UniTrack. So, metaphorically speaking, this will let the cat out of the bag as to what the next review will be, as this will be the workhorse of all my future model train review videos that I will be doing throughout this year and beyond. This is the Kato power pack, and the reference number is 22-014. Does come with the 3-pin UK power pack, which is in the carton here, and there is a plug-in connector lead that you can use with almost any brand of track that you currently use, as it's just to tinned soldered wires with a plastic plug at the other end, and we will take a look at that in a wee moment, as I will pause the video whilst I remove all of the packaging. And now that I've removed the packaging, just before I go any further, I just want to point out that this Kato UniTrack power pack train controller is the UK and Ireland version, as it does have the 3-pin power pack. So the one in your country may vary, depends on which part of the world you may be viewing this video from. But here is the details on the back of the panel. I do hope that the lighting is appropriate, as I've just recently changed the bulb to a 90 watt clear halogen type, as I do try to improve on my videos, and this is the first one I've actually done for quite a long time as well. But if you wish to pause the video to read all of this, you may do so. Just opening up the carton insert, this just tells you how to connect everything up, and this is just a clip and plug and play, and complete with pictures of the train controller. So if you want to pause that to look at those, you're most welcome to do so. And now for the fun part. Here is the actual train controller. It's actually quite lightweight, and this is your power and the reverser or directional switch forward. And I'm assuming with this controller, although I've not used it before, I've never used a Kato track controller before, I'm assuming that would be neutral or brake, and that's the reverse and such like. You do have a fixed 12 volts DC power supply on the side. This would power your switches and signals, etc., of which I will be working on a project in the future that should be interesting, but I'm not going to ruin any surprises. This is the input from your mains power supply, track output, and the reset button. This is just in case the controller gets overloaded or there's too much demand on the requested from the train controller. Although I believe this does have a 1.5 amp output. And for the price I paid for it, I certainly hope it is better than the standard Hornby train controllers. Anyways, So we've covered the AC adapter and the controller itself, which I'm just going to put back in there. This is just your standard plug and play lead, and I don't know if the camera is picking this up, and you've just got two tinned wires where you can solder them directly to your track or use a clamp to attach them to your existing model railway if you wish to use this train controller with other branded track. Well, that concludes my video. But likewise, I do appreciate all positive and constructive feedback. And if you have any comments or questions, please feel free to post them in the comment section below. Until next time, take care and cheerio.